Nitya, sorry for the technical glitch. Let's start with the sutra, the Shastra Pramana today. We'll be playing the Shastra Pramana first, and from the Shastra Pramana, we'll go to the Apta Pramana and Atma Pramana and go to the power manifestation. So let's start with the Shastra Pramana.
The Shastra Pramana for the power of remote vision is taken from the Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, Sutra 92, Dharana 69. Vyomakaram Swamatmanam Dhyaye Digbir Anavritam Nirashraya Chitik Shakti Swarupam Darshayetada Vyomakaram Swam Atmanam Dhyaye Digbir Anavritam Nirashraya Chiti Shakti Swarupam Darshayetada. The translation of this verse goes:
so beautiful. Swamiji is given a Shastra Pramana, Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, Sutra 92, Dharana 68. Concentrate and cognize on the restful awareness on the self in the form of vast etheric space and sky, which is limitless in any direction whatsoever. Thus, Chikshakti, the power of consciousness, freed from all support, reveals and manifests herself as a form of one's essential nature of the self. When we fall in love with something, we just melt in that. That is what Swamiji said, the eternal bliss. When we taste the eternal bliss, even the small beauty of a butterfly or a raindrop or some beautiful picture or some beautiful movie, whatever, we just fall for the something more than the logic always. Something we are seeking more than the logic. When we understand, when we let go this, whatever we are experienced with the logical senses, and it's not the senses which gives us the ultimate bliss. So when we let go and connect to Swamiji, when we are able to melt ourselves in the higher cognition, in a Ishta Devata or in the deity that we worship, or Swamiji himself, the Paramashiva in us, when we start tasting the ultimate which we are searching for, we will simply melt down from everything that we are seeing. Sorry, we are waiting for MTV. There's a little delay. Nityanandam, sorry for the technical. Today it's been a technical glitch day. So let's start seeing the beautiful space of what Paramashiva is giving us. Here he is asking us to wait so patiently. There's a beautiful thing. When the elephant falls in a ditch, the water all comes out. But the elephant goes in a ocean, nothing comes out. Even you have a big problem, when you have the bigger bliss, the ultimate bliss inside you, nothing shakes it. You simply are, you know, in such a peaceful, restful awareness in yourself. When you just melt in Swamiji, that's what exactly happens. However big your problems are, simply it dissolves and it doesn't even have a little shake. All our problems are like the elephant falling in the ditch is what we perceive, but actually it is in the ocean. We forget that we are ocean of bliss. We are consciousness. We keep associating us as a little ditch where we are confused. When we understand the highest possibility that we are the ocean and simply anything and everything can happen, still we'll be in such restful awareness. Swamiji beautifully gives us a state space and makes us manifest powers. It's not the powerful cognition that he says how he downloaded Sanskrit and how his guru really taught him. And he enacts that in our real Leela to show us how he's manifesting that. And also he tells us how the Shastras are helping us to understand the higher reality. Each and everything that he is giving us to map the consciousness again and again into the inner space so that the inner space is blissful, happy. Whatever we are going through, if we understand, it's like the elephant, which is not just falling the ditch, but it's in the ocean, doesn't even disturb the ocean. Whatever we are going through cannot be more than that. If we simply understand that being in the bliss, if you are depressed, the depression is what is reflected as a perception. If you be in the bliss, at least you can overcome the depression also, which you really want to, and start seeing the higher reality in you. What matters to you most? When we are in love with something, we forget everything. We don't remember anything. Even somebody shouts at us, screams at us, literally throws it out, we still don't realize anything. That is why Swamiji says, if you taste the eternal nectar, even little bit, even one little bit, you consciously cognize it. Even once, you don't have to wait 12 years. Simply, it will unfold right now. You have to decide to raise yourself and understand the conscious bliss that you are. That is what here he says, cognize with restful awareness. The self is a form of vast etheric space, as limitless in direction whatsoever. Chik Shakti, from the chik, all the consciousness which is awakened, start experiencing that whole as you. The everything which is happening in the universe is you. It's not just the little kingdom that you are living in, but the whole universe is your kingdom where you manifest your reality. So let's go to the instruction. Before the instruction, I want to play a small clipping of remote vision of Hanuman, how just in the Ramanama, by chanting the Mahavakya, he's able to open up and find Sita. So we're going to play the small clipping of in the Ramayana, how Hanuman finds Sita, the beauty that she is, the grace that she is. Just by the presence of her, he's able to locate her. And he goes around seeing and then asks Rama's help and chants the Ramanama and simply finds her. We're going to have the Apta Pramana of Hanuman to the higher reality that he was able to find. The beautiful Apta Pramana that Swamiji is giving us again and again, just by chanting the Mahavakya and holding your Atmalinga, simply you will be able to manifest the beautiful powers of the remote vision. Now we'll post the instruction. Before the instruction, I want to you to see how many Shakshi Pramana that people have manifested in scanning the unknown places. In the Sri Kailasha Kotiyar Manifesting Power Group, we have so many sharings, and so beautifully people have shared the great leelas of Paramashiva, how they have manifested the power of remote view. The remote vision that Swamiji is giving us is real. Paramashiva is real. And when you're in bliss and connecting to Swamiji as ultimate devotion, ultimate jnana, and how Swamiji says, if you map the higher reality into you as in your inner space with bliss, simply you will see that you will manifest the power of remote vision also. You can also go into the Facebook and see later. Now we'll post the instruction for you to manifest the power of remote vision of unknown places. Just write some unknown places, and when you're chanting the Mahavakya, whatever appears, you can start writing the situation or events or happenings of those places. And after that, you can Google and see, and simply you will be surprised to see exactly you are able to have the vision. So let's sit straight with your head, neck, and back in a straight line. Contemplate on the great truth that Swamiji is giving, the anthology of how he is mapping the greatest reality, the ultimate reality, Paramashiva, into our inner space as a volcano of bliss. Again and again, you have to raise yourself beyond what is happening. If you are stuck, that elephant is too big, my problems are too big, you are stuck in the space, you're thinking that you are in the ditch. But understand, you are in the ocean of bliss. You are Paramashiva. You are the ultimate. So anything and everything will just dissolve in the bliss. The mountain, the volcano of bliss, can just take anything and convert it to bliss. So be in the ultimate space of oneness with Paramashiva. Even the slight remembrance of Swamiji will put you into ecstasy. Again and again, bring him to the space of inner space and connect to him in the oneness, and chant the Mahavakya. Each time you chant the Mahavakya, you're opening your Anandaganda, the Dvadashanta that Swamiji described, literally connects you to the higher reality and make you manifest these powers. So let's start chanting the Mahavakya. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Shivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Shivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Shivoham. शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
शिवोऽहम्
Sadashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Yes, such a beautiful space. Please go ahead and verify what Swamiji has given us today in the remote vision of unknown places, the happenings, the situation. If you have shared with a partner, please ask the partner or Google it and you can share it with us in the Sri Kailasha Courtyard Manifesting Power Group. Every day we ask you to share, because sharing is the enriching, which is pulling you out of delusion. Again and again, when we share what we cherish deep inside us, is what continuously we'll be chanting, Swamiji says. So go ahead and tell everybody how amazing this space of Paramashiva in you manifesting as your reality itself. Whenever you chant the Mahavakya, Sharada Devi every day chanted the Ram Ram about a lakh time, but she was so busy throughout the day. And how she chanted is during the whole day, she would be going at the background, continuously chanting the Ram Ram. Such a beautiful space that even Sharada Devi was able to experience. So chanting the Mahavakya that you're initiated into is the ultimate gift. You can open your doors to the ocean of bliss. So go ahead and chant the Mahavakya continuously as many times as possible. Whenever you remember, will make you manifest all the powers of Paramashiva. Any problem that happens will have a solution because of the bliss that you are in, and your chanting Mahavakya opens you up to cause that as your reality instead of the past. So please go ahead and share this powerful cognition to as many people as possible and cause them and bring them to the satsang. When you cause others, you start getting liberated from your thinking. The more of Swamiji in us, the more people we speak and bring the shift in them is actually the shift in us. When causing, we are doing nothing except shifting our identity into the ultimate bliss. So go ahead and cause as many people. That's the easiest way to get liberated. Such a beautiful space Swamiji has created for us to offer Pratyaksha Pada Puja and Tulabharam on the great day when they are celebrating the Kumbhabhisheham for the temple. So you can go and enroll yourself on Jan 30th for the Pada Puja. the ultimate bliss that Swamiji raises you. We doing everything is one side, but when Swamiji pulls you, it is completely ultimate space to Sri Kailasha itself. So experience that ultimate space when you surrender to Bhagavan's Paduka. Anytime you offer any of these powerful cognition, power manifestation to that lotus feet, you will raise yourself into the ultimate reality. Again and again, Guru's lotus feet is the ultimate space a seeker needs to have, because it raises them to the beautiful oneness with Paramashiva. So let's surrender to Swamiji's lotus feet with a deep devotion and deep prayerful space with gratitude, asking Swamiji to manifest this as your existential reality itself. With that, let's visualize Swamiji in the third eye and end with the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Paramashiva Padukarpanamastu. Om Nityanandam. Thank you so much, and make sure you come for the next Manifesting Power session and the Powerful Cognition in the Satsang. Don't miss the Satsang. Satsang is really your life. How Swamiji said again and again, Satsang, he initiates you, give you darshan, and gives you the boon to raise you to the conscious divine space itself. Just attending and being in listening, we'll be in the state of bliss and manifesting that in our life. So thank you so much. Nityanandam.